So something that's been a little bit of an undercovered and kind of overshadowed story is that this Saturday, Yuriorkis Gamboa is going to be coming back, returning in a fight card taking place in Cancun, Mexico. He's going to be fighting against Alexis Reyes of Mexico. It's going to be a card televised on Televisa, the major network in down in Mexico, one of the major fight networks. You know, you see very frequently the likes of Finito Lopez, Juan Manuel Marquez, Barrera, Morales, etc. You know, that doing the coverage for a lot of the big fights, a lot of the big stateside fights, a lot of big international fights for Televisa. And Gamboa is in basically a do-or-die situation. I see that this fight is listed at featherweight, although I'm not entirely sure if it's going to be taking place at the 126-pound limit. As you guys may remember recently, Yuriorkis Gamboa's two recent fights against Rene Alvarado and against Robinson Castellanos were both basically kind of above super featherweight, slightly above super featherweight, ostensibly like lightweight fights, basically. You know, Gamboa weighed 131 for Alvarado in the unanimous decision win that he got over him. A fairly hard-fought unanimous decision win, but Alvarado's a bit of a spoiler. And then Robinson Castellanos, another spoiler, went in there. The two of them both weighed in at 133 officially. And Gamboa wound up retiring after the seventh round. Got dropped a couple of times in round 3 and 4 and was just getting kind of pot-shotted, pinpointed. You know, and Castellanos showed that it wasn't a fluke. I mean, it hadn't been a fluke before, you know, when he upset the likes of Ronnie Rios, Rocky Juarez, and, I mean, looked like he was coming close to potentially upsetting Jezra Corrales in his most recent fight on HBO, as I'm sure a lot of you guys saw. And it's kind of funny to me, because, like, you know, you see Corrales kind of have some trouble with Castellanos, and now all of a sudden, like, everybody's, like, dissing on Corrales, like, oh, he must not have been that good, and, you know, certain guys who won't be mentioned here would, oh, destroy him and this and that. But, I mean, Castellanos gives everybody trouble. He gives everybody trouble. He's basically just like Orlando Salido, you know. He's the same type of a fighter, or a similar type of a fighter, but, you know, the same spoiling aspect that he possesses. I think, technically speaking, he's a little bit better than Salido, especially on the outside. Salido's a bit better of an inside fighter, but two very similar general kind of histories between those two guys. A lot of losses, particularly early in their careers, but guys that definitely grew and learned from those losses and will give anybody trouble on any given night and could potentially beat the best fighters at 126 or 130 on any given night. You know, it's just one of those things. If you come in half-stepping against guys like that, you could be potentially either looking up at the lights or you could be on the wrong end of a decision because they, you know, they just made you fight their fight, and that's just the way it goes, you know. So they didn't even show that against Lomachenko. But getting back to Gamboa, you know, this is a do-or-die fight most certainly for him. Alexis Reyes doesn't have really the history of like a Castellanos or an Alvarado. He hasn't necessarily shown himself to be a spoiler heretofore. You know, he's a guy that's 15-2 with one draw, 7 knockouts. His most recent fight against Alejandro Zuniga, who's an undefeated prospect, he lost that fight. So just looking at things generally, Gamboa should be able to defeat Reyes. You know, he should be able to defeat this guy. But, you know, knowing Reyes, knowing a lot of fighters from Mexico, even guys with just one or two losses, you know, in Mexico, you don't really get soft touch matches by and large. I mean, you're getting thrown in there tough. I mean, ask Juan Manuel Marquez, ask Rafael Marquez. They were fighting in like 10 rounders their first fight, fighting against straight up seasoned pros. You know what I mean? And you know, unfortunately for them, you know, or in Juan Manuel's case, taking a loss. But you know, you get thrown in tough, and you definitely got to learn on the job. You know, so you get good in a real hurry, or you get gone in a real hurry. And so it's entirely possible. Who knows? Reyes may be able to kind of young man the old man. You know, he's 22. But we'll see. You know, we shall see. This is definitely a do or die fight for Gamboa. I just definitely wanted to put it on the radar. Incidentally, it's actually not the main event of this card. The main event, I believe, is going to be Francisco Chihuas Rodriguez taking on Elias Joaquino. Rodriguez is a former unified strawweight champion. I think he had the WBO and the IBF titles. Defeated Katsunari Takayama, the legendary Takayama. Recently retired, trying to go out for the 2020 Olympics in Japan, trying to represent the home country now. So Chihuas Rodriguez is going to be headlining the card against an undefeated, up-and-coming kind of contender in Joaquino. In addition to that, there's going to be a world female heavyweight title fight on that card as well. Alejandra Jimenez versus Vanessa LePage Joannice. So that might be kind of interesting too, if we manage to get some footage of this entire card, because who knows, maybe somebody like a Clarissa Shields will try and do some Roy Jones-esque things in the women's boxing divisions. And then also note on this card is Oscar Cantu, super flyweight/flyweight contender. He recently had a bit of a close, somewhat controversial loss to Austin Palite. But as a guy that you may be seeing him at some point in the near future, as long as he keeps up his winning ways, you know, from here on out, may see him in some sort of a WBC or other, you know, alphabet title world championship fight against the likes of maybe a Chocolatito or Night Inoue, or at flyweight against Daigo Higa or Kazuto Yoka, somebody like that. Because he is highly ranked in several of the organizations, and he's kind of a floater. You know, he fights at flyweight and super flyweight, just kind of depending on what notice they're able to give an opponent. Fighting against a 10-1 opponent, Joaquin Cruz. And, you know, if Joaquin Cruz manages to defeat him, he'll pretty much kind of take the juice that that Oscar Cantu has. You know, he'll be able to kind of take that leverage of having a high rating on forward, and maybe potentially kind of take his place in terms of being a high-level contender, possibly getting into one of these bigger fights, since now, like, a lot of the major networks are taking a bit more notice of the lightweight divisions. But that's going to pretty much do it for this video. I definitely just wanted to put Gamboa on the radar. Let's see if he looks good. Let's see if he gets back in form and gets back on his road to another potential title run. Let's see. If he loses this fight, it may be start to look like the end for Gamboa. You know, I wasn't too hard on him for losing to Castellanos, as some people might have been, because, you know, there's a lot of boxer scholars out here that will see that, oh, Castellanos has 12 losses, so that means he's not any good. Well, he just fucking ran 50-50 with the best fighter at the 130-pound division, Jesuel Corrales. So, you know, that shows you what people can actually just learn from looking at some fucking numbers on a website. But that's all I got to say for this one. I'll catch you guys on the next one. Peace.